time it is. It's MightyFan's time. Hope you like my new intro to my videos. I figured, you know, a bunch of the other Jersey heads have their own personal intros, so let me do the same. I know I had one for a little while, but I thought I could do an update for it, so hope you guys enjoyed that. Before I get into the main focus of this video, I do have a special shout-out I want to give to our newest Jersey head in the Jersey head community. His handle on YouTube is Silver Lightning 05, so there you go. I wrote it down just so I remember to give this shout-out. A big shout-out to you, Silver Lightning 05. Great vids by you. Great collections by you to this point. I'm very envious of that rookie year Steve Young Tampa Bay Buccaneers jersey. I've been looking for that one. That's definitely a top most wanted in the NFL throwback circuit for me. I mean, I kind of wish some, kind of was wondering sometime maybe of making old school, from those Western movies and stuff, those wanted posters, put some in the back of some of the, my all-time jersey grails, but that would certainly be one of them. But, you know, that being said, that's besides the point. Great collection by you, and keep them coming, keep those videos coming, and good stuff by you. So now to the main point of this video. This is a pickup video, but I thought I would do it Mr. Crispy Coyle style because we all know our good friend Mr. Crispy Coyle. You never know what you're going to find in his pickup videos. He always has a selection of stuff. So that being said, shout out to Mr. Crispy Coyle. And I thought over the past few weeks, I've added a few things to different collections, the Lids collection and the jersey collection. I know I said I'd take a little break on the jersey collection, but jersey collecting for a few months, but, you know, I got too good a deal on this. I couldn't pass it up, and it is one that I passed up two straight years at the Super Bowl sale, Mitchell and them, believe it or not. I passed it up then, saying I know I can get it cheaper on eBay, and that's exactly what I did. So let's get to that first. I am speaking of circa 1989, Mitchell and Ness, number 33, San Francisco 49ers. A little West Coast swag for you guys in this video. For all the West Coast viewers, there you go, from Diego to the Bay. Diego to the Bay. I like that song, by the way. A-Rock, shout out to you. but yeah, San Francisco 49ers, Roger Craig. You're really nice jersey. Like I said, I passed on a few times in a row, a few years in a row during various sales at Mitchell & Ness, the Black Friday sale, and of course the Super Bowl sale, but I knew I could get it cheaper. I knew I could do it, and I did. But I never imagined I'd get it this cheap. And more about that later, but first let's get to the jersey. It's got the jock tag right there. This is the newer made in China version, but it's still a very nice jersey. It's got the single stitch 33 in the front. It's got the single stitch 33 on the sleeves. And the sleeve, the only thing that isn't stitched on this jersey are the stripes on the sleeves. They're that kind of vinyl heat pressed on. There you go. Not stitched. They are heat pressed on. Really cool. Of course, you all know I love heat pressed stuff on football jerseys or any jersey. The Craig, name Craig on the back is on a nameplate. Single stitched, and the 33, of course, single stitched on the back. Roger Craig, of course, being a great running back in the day, multi-threat running back, could run, could receive. It's kind of like Marshall Faulk before Marshall Faulk, you know, back in the day. Just a great running back. Should be in the Hall of Fame. I mean, a lot of those members of those 49er teams are in the Hall of Fame, but not Roger Craig. So I kind of hope he gets in someday. Great running back, like I said. I'm trying to get as many of the all-time great running backs in my collection as I can. Roger Craig was one that I passed on a few times at the during different sales at Mitchell & Ness, but I didn't pass on it this time on eBay, so I had a purpose. now onto the deal for this jersey. This was actually a buy it now of $50, but it also had the ever popular make an offer on there. Now $50 shipped. It was shipped also, no free shipping. Was a great deal alone for this, but I figured, let me try to get it even cheaper. So, you know me, I'm all about the deal, so I offered $30. The seller was kind enough to accept that. Boom, there it was. $30 for the Mitchell & Ness Roger Craig jersey. So, yeah, saved a lot of money by not getting it at the Super Bowl sale a couple years in a row. But I knew I can get it cheaper, and I was right. Did not expect to get this cheap, like I said, but there you go. Now, I do have a 49ers hat somewhere in the collection to go with this jersey, but since it's not in my hand right now, I got to go with, for swag factor, Another red and white, boom, Phillies. There you go. Or I can go red, too, but going with the hometown Phillies. So, yes, Roger Craig, 1989, 49ers. Throwback that I passed on a couple times at Mitchell & Ness during their sales. So there you go. It was meant to be. Okay, now on to the other pickups. You all know that I'm not only a big jersey, and by the way, I'm wearing my St. Patrick's Day Tug McGraw because this is the first video that I'm making since St. Patrick's Day. So it's a little late, but better late than never, right? So I got my Phillies green attire on, you know, for a happy belated St. Patrick's Day. And it's still a month of March. So there you go. But yes, I'm not only a big jersey collector, but I'm also a hat collector. I wear hats all the time, so I was at the anytime take advantage of a sale. You know, I try to do that, and the local lids was having had a buy one get one half off deal, including hats that were on sale. So I was able to get a couple hats on sale, and not only that, but get the second one half off, even though it was already on sale. So there you go. Oh, you know, we always look for the deal. That's right. I'm a Hawkeye when it comes to that kind of stuff. So let's get right to it. All right, here we go. Red Sox Nation, there you go. Boston Red Sox. My pick for this year's World Series, Red Sox versus my Phillies. With my Phillies winning in 7. Remember that, Boston. Remember that, Sox Nation. You just ride it. I said it. We'll be talking again in October. Hey, it's March, but I can make my prediction. It's about a week and a half away from baseball season, so it's prediction time for my event. I've been off of my prediction a couple of years. I was right in 08 when I said the Phillies would win. So I wasn't right in 09 and 10, but 2011, my event's coming back. But yes, I do believe they will play the Red Sox, and they will beat the Red Sox, because that's the way my fans see it. Anyhow, there you go. Red Sox. I've always liked this logo, by the way, the two red socks there. So I just like saying socks, socks, socks. And there they are on the back. Socks Nation. There you go. But I'm Phillies Nation, of course. Phillies Nation. Anyhow. So I got the Red Sox, and that goes real well with my Wade Boggs mesh batting practice Mitchell & Ness jersey. So there you go. Now this particular hat, I don't think it's going to go well with just about anything. I don't have anything in this color. But I had to get this because it was just too bananas a color to pass on. And look at this. You can see me in pitch black with this hat on. This is like a lime neon green. And believe it or not, this is a Detroit Tigers hat. So shout out to Eminem. Here's the Detroit D. You got Detroit going on the side. And these hats, by the way, are style hats. They're not hats that players actually wear. I think we know that with this one. Although it would be kind of interesting. Even if the Tigers wore a hat with that neon green D on the front, that would definitely be different. The back there and the underbrim, look at that. The Tigers on the bottom. Isn't that just something? That just is mind-boggling, the colors on this hat here. This is just, yeah. So there you go. And this past weekend, I was back in the mall with a buddy of mine, and again, Liz was having the same sale. These hats were on sale, and I bought one, got one half off on sale. So it was almost like, you know, people, you know, combine coupons and, you know, stack coupons on different sites and all that stuff. Well, it's the same. When you go to stores, sometimes things are on sale, and then they have to buy one, get one half off. It's already on sale. You get a sale on top of the sale. My fan knows how to find deals. I wait for them. I see hats at Lids, and they're full price, and I say, give it a couple months. You'll start seeing the sales stickers on. Now, of course, for fitted on-field baseball hats, it's a little different, but for the style hats, you can usually find them cheap or late if you just wait. It's just a little tip from my evening. But yes, I got the Phillies maroon and powder blue. Look at that. I mean, that does it right there. So, of course, this goes with the 79 Mike Schmidt maroon jersey. This goes with the 76 Dave Cash. And I have a lot of Philly shirts that, and, you know, hoodies and stuff like that in these colors too, so they go well with a lot of things that I wear. Philly's wise, so there you go. Old school. So there you go. Shout out to all my fellow Philly fans out there. So yes, these are both New Era, of course. The back, just the MLB logo, the back of that was pretty cool because it had the little Philly's design there with the Philly, the old school Philly P. It's got the powder blue button on the top there. Real nice. Just can't go wrong with either one, I don't think. There you go. I think I have like a different Phillies hat for every day of the month. I could probably wear a different one, including this one, by the way. I always get compliments on this one. There you go, a little green action there. A little different. That's how Mighty Fan rolls. Anyhow, different Phillies hat every day. And people at work are like, how many hats do you have? I'm like, I can fill a store. But at any rate, those are my recent pickups. I just wanted to make this video a little overdue. Like I said, I had that Craig jersey about a week or so ago. I've been busy with work and school, and I felt remiss by not making a video. I apologize I didn't make one sooner, but like I said, when you're busy, you're busy. So there you go. Better late than ever, like I say. So at any rate, that's going to do it for MightyFan's, for my pickups. Hope you guys enjoyed this Mr. Crispy Coyle style pickup video. Again, shout out to Mr. Crispy Coyle, my fellow Philly fan, fellow Philly native. And, of course, a big shout out to all the rest of my fellow Jersey Heads. Big shout out to Silver Lightning 05, again, our newest member of the Jersey Heads community. Big shout out to all my subscribers. Of course, thank you so much for subscribing to my vids. Keep subscribing, and also to my, subscribe to the rest of my fellow Jersey Heads as well. My family and friends, big shout out to you guys too. It's MightyFan's saying peace. I'll see you in the next video.